These roundtables are full of Pinays who are learning from the experiences of various authors in the Filipino Women's Network's Disrupt book series. Each are divided up into groups that focus on specific areas of careers. This is all part of an event called Filipinas in Motion.
So we have Filipinas in government, Filipinas in education, Filipinas in politics, Filipina entrepreneurs, Filipinas in finance, Filipinas in tech. And so the guests and the members, when they come in, they sit with them. And so that way they are able to have focused networking instead of just standing around saying hi, hello.
The authors and contributors are recipients of the Filipino Women's Network 100 Most Influential Filipino Women in the World Award.
All these Filipina disruptor stories are there to help inspire and motivate us to do what we can to achieve our goals, which should include gender balance. A true sustainable world is only possible if we have equality for all.
Cora Tayez, CEO and founder of Sterling Health Services Administration, gave the keynote speech of the evening. Tayez was named president and CEO of HealthNet, a Fortune 500 company in 1998, making her the youngest woman CEO at the time and the first Pinay to achieve this feat. She was also the past president and chair of Prudential Healthcare Plan of California and CEO of Blue Shield of California. Tayez offers these pieces of advice.
One is that success is a group sport. And what we've got to remember is it's important to build alliances and to have allies as we move up. The second thing is to take risks. You can't be a leader if you're always following the status quo and you are afraid to speak up.
The Filipino Women's Network says it was important to show Pinays that there are those like them who are at the top of their fields, like Tayez, in order to motivate them and make them believe it is possible to reach for such a position. According to organizers, the event was also inspired by recent legislation.
There's a law in California that passed last year that large corporations have to have one or two women on the board. Otherwise, they have to pay a fine.
The Filipino Women's Network is already looking at either Dubai or Monaco for the next Pinay Summit. Ramel Kinclair, ABS-CBN News, San Francisco.